second video from Audley Brewing. I'm obviously not someone called Audley. What I'm going to do today is I received the package this morning and I'm going to unbox it. It was going to be a massive surprise as to what it is. However, as you can see, it's all very well liveried on the box. So I've ordered a Brewzilla. Took the plunge there just before Christmas. Heard great things about it, seen a few people using them on different videos, things like that. So decided I'd get myself one just to streamline my own process a wee bit. So just going to open it. I have to say, before we go any further, I got this from a company in England called BrewKegTap.co.uk. Ordered directly from them, and I have to say I'm very, very impressed with the customer service. These have obviously come from the land down under, and there was a problem with shipping over December, Christmas period, and the lads at BrewKegTap have kept us very much informed, emailing us regularly, giving us up to the expected dates. This would have arrived yesterday had I not been at work, so it's actually arrived a day earlier than their estimation, their last estimation. So can't praise them guys enough. Fantastic customer service. So first thing I've noticed, open the box, we've got my invoice, and please read first. Blah 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 blah. Blah 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 blah. Warranty. I've got an envelope which has, hopefully you can see, connects for hose lock. Is that what it's called? Putting on your garden hose anyway. Although they actually look quite similar to Brew. Actually, that's exactly what they are. Look like quick connects for a keg. I'll put them here. What else is in here? Nothing. Beer mat. Always handy to have a beer mat. Sticker. Advertise things. So lots of bubble wrap, some polystyrene here. Safety first, never play with knives. A glass circle with a hole in it. Obviously a lid of some description. I'll keep the bubble up. Pipe with a, I'm gonna say U-bend, but it's more like an N-bend. And a handle. I know what this is for. I've seen people use the Brewzilla before, so that there is for lifting the mash bucket out. And that there is for recirculating the wort. I don't know if you can see them, maybe bring them up closer. A few delicate nuts, washers, and a ring pull thing there. I'll keep that safe. Top of the beer mat, remind me. I've got two black balls and a silver thing with a black thing inside it. Probably gonna have to do a video of building this bloody thing. Hey ho. I'm not a plumber, but I'm guessing that's a tap. And that's my polystyrene. Next level. A hop stand thing for putting hops in. Very handy. One I have is about yay size, so very pleased with that. If nothing else works. It's run away from me. Right, a coil chiller. So these brass connections here will obviously screw on there. Is my theory. And then the hose can go on top of that. It's only a theory, might not be the case. Chiller. A few other bits of polystyrene. Greta Thunberg is not going to be happy. Super thick neoprene, Brewzilla branded. It's obviously an insulation jacket. What else have we got here? Is this all going to come as one unit? I think it might. No, it's not. Excuse me. More wrapping paper. Paper's recyclable though, right? Okay, so for the untrained eye, this is a silver circle thing. It could be a 90s rap video filmed in there. But you'll see, a bit closer to you again, you'll see there's notches here, which give us a clue as to what it actually is. As you see down here, I don't know if you can see that in the camera, but that there has a lip inside it. So that's a clue. That's going to be the grain bucket. And then other things in here, more wrapping paper. It's like Christmas. This. Okay, so there's two things in this. Actually, there's three things in this. So I just want to make sure I don't lose nothing. Don't lose anything. So no nothing, that's all negatives. So we've got a pipe thing. That's exactly what I didn't want to happen. So we have this pipe thing. It comes with an extra pipe inside it. And a spring clip to keep it in place. A mesh, you see through. It has two bevels there. Not quite sure. Another mesh, finer mesh. You can see that. And a third one, which is slightly more solid and has a screw fitting in the middle this time. And this has a screw there, so that also screws in there in some way, shape, form or fashion. Maybe it goes that way, I don't know. So put that there. Then we have more bubble wrap. More mesh. This one has three, I'm going to say handles, but they're definitely not handles. And a very small bit at the top, which this obviously will not fit through. So it's obviously part of the grain stuff there. I don't know how much of me you can actually see in this. I've sort of tested a couple of times, but then I've moved about. There's something there that I can't quite get out. Okay, I'll just lift the next bit out, the big bit. That's all that's in the box. Piece of tubing. Flexible, soft, squishy tubing. Obviously with polystyrene here was a thing, but you can see already without me opening it anymore, because that's the main body of the unit. Let's see, where's the, just using my knife here to cut some salt out. So I'm pretty much at the end of unpacking here, and I'm just taking some bits and pieces off. I have to say, whilst Miss Thunberg won't be too happy with the amount of packaging used, I'm very impressed that, on the face of it at least, there's no damage here. No marks, no scrapes, nothing. So this has come, sorry, try to get back up the camera. This has come from down under, Australia, New Zealand, that sort of direction, to England, and then from England to Ireland. And as far as I can tell, there's no damage at all to any component or the main body. One slight scrape there. Slight discoloration there, but other than that, you know, that's just the same where the aluminium's the stainless steel's combined. And then down here we've got our rough marks for the rough volume inside the unit. So I'm very impressed. I'm even more impressed if we can get this bit of cardboard out of here. Close. Yeah, so just one final bit of cardboard which has helped protect. There's like a nut down there and a thermometer probe right down the bottom. I assume that's what that is. I doubt you'll be able to see it. You see the wee nut, and then just immediately to the side of it, there's a wee like bevel, which is a thermometer probe by my desk, yes. So there's a bit of construction needing done. Obviously you need to put the tap on. You need to work out how to connect the pump up to the recirculation, power switches, heating elements, and the control panel. In terms of destructions, I don't see any. So I might be going on to YouTube to learn how to build this. Please read the full instruction manual before you start brewing. This can be downloaded at kegland.com.au. Brackets, the manufacturer no longer includes a physical manual. So all of this packaging, but to save the environment, we can't send you a bloody instruction book. Ho hum. So the first and most obvious thing to do, and the bit that I know I can do myself, is put the tap under the hole at the front. I'm not going to do a construction video. I might video bits and pieces of what I get done. So what I'm going to do is build it, read the instruction book, build it, and then I'm going to just run a hot water cycle through it, clean out any chemicals that we use to clean it.
Okay, so we're back in the kitchen, and now we can see construction is complete.
Construction of the unit.
So
I'm very happy with this. I'll be more happy once we get there.
You can see the water sort of flickering, coming into focus. Just over 10 litres in there, just for a demonstration, and to run some water through the pump and clean out some chemicals and stuff. So it's plugged in there. Obviously, we've tried my normal kitchen shit, so my actual kettle and the toaster and crumbs and all that sort of bollocks. So here we have the control panel. Moving the dishes out of the way. We've got 1900 watt, 500 watt heaters, both in the zero position. And round the front, I'm calling this the front, we have pump, also in the zero condition. So we'll turn it on. And it's alive. Push the on button. So the water's at 10 degrees and I want it to be let's see if we can heat it up to 50 degrees. So I've hit play, and you can see there, I don't know if you can because of the Brewzilla, the 500 watt heater is on, and we can see it's doing something. Now because I have the mash stuff and all in there, you'll not actually see the bubbles come up from the element. So when you're doing your actual mash, 500 watts is dead on, but we'll fire both of them on and hopefully we'll get hotter quicker. So as you can see, we're approaching, we're at 47. Probably should have timed this to give myself a bit of an idea. So both heating elements on. So 1900 and 500, what's up? 2400 watts, heating this water up. I guess that's what you would do when you're heating the water up before the mash, and then you would turn the 1900 off to maintain the temperature for the mash, and then flick the 19 back on for the boil or whatever. But we're about to see what actually happens when it hits the target temperature. Hopefully there'll be some sort of an alarm. You can see like an on off button, temperature set, timer, auto or manual, your plus or minus buttons for changing things, and then S1 to S6, this is your presets, so you've like stepped mashes and stuff like that, and then play or pause, so I can pause it now, it'll not keep heating up. So any minute now, we will go. Literally any minute, there we go. So no alarm goes off. That's disappointing. But you've seen there both heating elements turned themselves off. So that's a bit disappointing. I wonder if I had a set a timer, you know, if that was to go up to boil and it had to boil for an hour or whatever, I set a timer, then with the timer now start. A few bits and pieces, obviously, I'm going to have to learn about this machine. So there it's dropping down again. I wonder how low does it have to go before the heaters come back on. Anyway, that's not really all that important. So the next thing then, I have been playing about a bit with this. This is the pump button. It's very important with this pump. It's one of those magnetic pumps. But Jacko, water is not magnetic. How does it work? I've no idea, but it uses magnets anyway to pump shit through. So the important thing is that it never runs dry. Even running it dry for a very short period of time will damage it. So taps in line, that means the water can go through. And then you can use this to adjust the flow. So I'll turn it on. And you can probably hear that water trickling in. Turn it off again. I'll just show you something. My kitchen is a mess too. I've not done any housework this week. I'll take this lid off. I'll sit you down. Had a cup of coffee while I was waiting. So you can take this off. Now this is only heated up to 50, so this isn't too warm, but these handles are a godsend. Just be careful of condensation. So again, this is only 50, so I'll turn it on. You see the water coming out there. That's a full flow. So I adjust this handle, which you can't see because I'm trying to do three things with one hand. You can see I can adjust that so that it doesn't come out as fast. And that's really what you do there. Now, I don't know if this is a design, I think it's maybe more by accident, but there's a safety thing here where this ring pull here prevents you being able to turn that completely off because that would damage the pump. And as you can see then, if there was grain in there, that would be a recirculation. And the heaters have come back on, it's obviously dropped down below. So there we are, I'm quite happy with that. I'll probably turn that on to heat up. Basically two boiling.
So that's it unpacked, and water run through it there at 50 degrees. I'm about to head out actually for a few bits and pieces tonight of things to do tonight. What I'm going to do now is set up basically to boil. See how long it takes to get from 50 to boiling, shouldn't take too long. And then just run some boiling water through it to basically kill off any nasties that are in it, try and get away any chemicals that were in it for cleaning it while it was being made or do the construction thing. And meanwhile I'll get up, get showered, get ready to go out. I'm really happy with the kit I've got here, although I didn't do a brew day on it tonight, this evening. It will be done shortly, in the next week or so my first brew will be done on it. It'll be getting a good clean star sand, the works, and we'll give it a go. I'll probably do a manual brew on it, so you can do it manually, even though it's an automatic, you know, I could do it automatically, but I want to learn the manual system first before I start trying to venture into complicated automatic programs and stuff like that. So it's going to be a bit of a learning curve. My brews that I'm going to do next, I'm going to do a colch in this, which my first video was a wee bit about a disaster of a colch that I made there on New Year's Day. So hopefully, looking at maybe Wednesday or Thursday next week, today's Friday, so Wednesday, Thursday next week will be colch brew day. I need to free up a fermenter, so yeah, that's okay. And then brew day after that, which might do it at the same time, I'll probably do it, if I can get this done on Wednesday, I'll do the second one on Thursday, which will be a kettle sour, which is new for me. I've never done one before. I've explained in the previous video why I'm going to do it. And I'm going to use my old three vessel system for that. I might use this Brewzilla for boiling or something. excuse me. I'll set up something, but I don't want this to have sour beer anywhere near it until I'm completely satisfied that I can get it back to doing proper beers. I've heard horror stories. So that's basically it for the unpacking and cleaning. Don't know if I cleaned it, but certainly quick run through. And then as I go through, I'll do a few bits and pieces and as I learn new features of the bloody thing, I will I'll certainly put them in videos.